You'd think Tiger Woods would have taken some time off to relax and recover after his knee surgery, but the world number one couldn't resist the temptation to get back on the course. But instead of playing, Tiger's joined a growing list of champions by designing his own golfing paradise. And with the world number one in charge, you wouldn't expect this one to be easy.
It'll be challenging, but also it'll be, it won't be brutal. It'll be tough on the back tees, it'll be 7,800. From the up tees, it'll be 5,300, and we'll have six different tee markers. So everyone can, you can have a mix of whatever you want, and that's what I want. I want to have playability. I don't want someone to go out there and say, this was a joke, this was too hard.
Woods has already achieved one miracle this year with his victory in the US Open, and he might need another one as he plans to turn the desert green.
The scale of this development is tremendously huge. The whole development includes 30,000 trees, 12 meters and above, and the shrubs are 480,000 shrubs coming from five countries around the world. So it's quite a dynamic project when we receive 20 open-ended containers for trees to be actually shipped into Dubai.
The development will be known simply enough as the Tiger Woods Dubai. It's scheduled to be completed in 2009, providing the builders can handle the tough conditions.
The wind blowing and then obviously the heat, the evaporation of water, the movement of sand. I mean, it is a challenge, but this is an oasis. I mean, you're going to come out here and just forget about where you are. And that's my job of an architect, is to try and design that. And we're doing a great job of that.